Hey everybody, what's happening? Son of a Silver Stacker here. In today's supplemental numismatic news and information for the 4th day of November 2021, I'd like to welcome you to join me back to JM Bullion so we can look at the live spot prices. Looks like gold is still up. It's $1475, $1785.67. Silver up 44 cents to $2377. Platinum up $19.78 to $1059.69. Palladium up $52.09 to $2081.75. Now over here to the Google machine, and there was an amazing announcement just yesterday about some gold coins found in Norfolk. So they've just been declared a treasure. Now it says here, this is out of BBC News, out of Norfolk 17 hours ago. The title of the article is Largest Anglo-Saxon Gold Coin Hoard Found in Norfolk. And this doesn't say who it's written by, but that's okay. Maybe it does somewhere along the article in the bottom. Now it says here, all the coins were found in a single field. Its owner and the detectorist who found the majority wished to remain anonymous. I can't blame them for that. These coins are probably going to be worth in the millions, I would think. And is it better to be famous than rich, or rich than famous, or both, or neither? Right, so that's definitely something to think about. The largest hoard of Anglo-Saxon gold coins to be found in England has been declared a treasure at an inquest. What does that mean, a treasure? So let's go here to the Wikipedia page, and this is from the Treasure Act of 1996. Now, it's a UK Act of Parliament defining which objects are classified as treasure, legally obliging the finder to report their find. Let's dig a little deeper here. So let's go ahead and just read this paragraph, and this is the provision that makes the most sense to talk to you about. The Act is designed to deal with finds of treasure in England, Wales, and Northern Ireland. It legally obliges finders of objects which constitute treasure, as defined in the Act, to report their find to their local coroner within 14 days. An inquest led by the coroner that then determines whether the find constitutes treasure or not. If it is declared to be treasure, then the finder must offer the item for sale to a museum at a price set by an independent board of antiquities experts known as the Treasure Valuation Committee. Only if a museum expresses no interest in the item or is unable to purchase it can the finder retain the item. Well, that's incredible. And there's the items that were found. Incredible. You know, look at that gold. It's beautiful. Beautiful. Now, four gold objects were discovered with 131 coins in a field in West Norfolk, most by the same anonymous metal detectorist who notified the appropriate authorities. 10 coins were found by a serving police officer who tried to sell them and was jailed for 16 months. Ouch. Ouch. Norwich Castle hopes to acquire them. The internationally significant hoard. So looks like this museum, right, or somebody wants to acquire them because they have been deemed treasure. Gareth Williams, curator of early medieval coins at the British Museum, said the hugely important find, which dates to the same era as the Sutton Hoo ship burial near Woodbridge in Suffolk, is that right? Yeah, is the largest coin hoard of the period known to date. And there they are again. That's beautiful. And it is the most important hoard found in Norfolk by a long way, according to coin expert Adrian Marsden. The first coin was discovered in 1991, but it was not until 2014 that further coins dating to about AD 610 were found. Could you imagine spending all that time from 91 to 2014 amassing this hoard, and then only to have it subject to an inquiry and only recently be declared a treasure in 2021? So 1991 to 2021, well, you can do the math. That's quite some time. Now it says here, numismatist Adrian Marsden from the Norfolk Historic Environment Service said all the coins were minted on the continent, as we did not have gold coins of our own at that time. This includes coins struck from the same die in the same workshop as those found in a purse, in a coin purse at the Sutton Hoo. And there it is. You can see the outline of the image of the figure. We don't know who that is. Imagine somebody does, though. A stamped gold pendant, a gold bar, and two other pieces of gold were found at the same time, suggesting the hoard should have been seen as bullion, valued by weight rather than face value. Dr. Marsden said it seems to have been built up by someone moving around the Merovingian kingdom. Oh, that's interesting. So it's somebody who was a collector, it seems like. And it was found near an Anglo-Saxon cemetery, and it may have been buried in a barrow. That was a Skyrim reference, a barrow, right? And scattered by centuries of plowing. Yeah, that makes sense. Now, Anglo-Saxons in East Anglia, 6th century kingdom of East Anglia, formed modern-day Norfolk and Suffolk. and so on and so forth. Now, the hoard includes coins not previously known to experts, and another that was only known through a drawing in a book dating to 1666, but has since been lost. Can you imagine? So this is definitely significant. The previous largest Anglo-Saxon coin hoard, 101 coins in a coin purse, was found at Crondall in Hampshire in 1828. The Staffordshire hoard, discovered in 2009 and dating back to the mid-7th century, does not include coins. Now, Norwich Castle and Art Gallery curator, these are the folks that want to buy these, curator Tim Pestel described it as an internationally significant find, which we've heard a couple times, which reflects the wealth and continental connections enjoyed by the early kingdoms of East Anglia. The hoard was declared a treasure at an inquest at Norfolk Coroner's Court in Norwich. And it doesn't say exactly when, but I imagine it was just recently, since this is news now. So how about that? Could you imagine finding all those wonderful gold coins and then having to submit them for an inquest at the coroner's office to find out if it's treasure or not? And what if it isn't declared treasure? Holy smokes. And I have no problem with that person wanting to remain anonymous. That is, I think, a smooth move. Definitely. Call you Silky after that one. Listen, folks, I want to thank you all for watching. Thanks for dropping by. Don't forget to hit that like button. And if you do like what you're hearing, see, please subscribe to the channel. It's free. Son of a Silver Stacker, out.